हेलो दोस्तों, मैं गौरव आप सबका स्वागत करता हूं मेरे यूट्यूब चैनल कोडन बायोलॉजी में।
आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन द कंटिन्यूइंग पॉडकास्ट ऑफ हाउ सेल्स नीड द जीनोम। ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ द न्यूक्लियोटाइड सीक्वेंस ऑफ एन मैसेंजर आरएनए मॉलिक्यूल इनटू कोडिन टेक्स प्लेस इन द साइटोप्लाज्म on a large ribonucleoprotein assembly called a ribosome. The amino acids used for protein synthesis are first attached to a family of tRNA molecules, each of which recognizes by complementary base pair interaction particular sets of three nucleotides in the messenger RNA from codons. The sequence of nucleotides in the messenger RNA is then read from one end to the other in the sets of three according to the genetic code. To initiate translation, a small ribosomal subunit bind to the messenger RNA molecule at a start codon, that is AUG. This is recognized by a unique initiator tRNA molecule. A large ribosomal subunit binds to complete the ribosome and begin protein synthesis. During this phase, aminoacyl tRNA each bring a specific amino acid bind sequentially to the appropriate codons in messenger RNA through complementary base pairing between tRNA anticodons and messenger RNA codons. Each amino acid is added to the C-terminal end of the growing polypeptide in four sequential steps. First, aminoacyl tRNA binding, followed by peptide bond formation, followed by two ribosome translocation steps. Elongation factors use GTP hydrolysis to drive these reactions forward and to improve the accuracy of amino acid selection. The messenger RNA molecule progresses codon by codon through the ribosome in the 5' to 3' direction until it reaches one of three stop codons. A release factor then binds to the ribosome, terminating translation and releasing the completed polypeptide. Eukaryotic and bacterial ribosomes are closely related. Despite differences in the number and size of their ribosomal RNA and protein components, ribosomal RNA has the dominant role in translation, determining the overall structure of the ribosome, forming the binding sites for the tRNAs, matching the tRNAs to codons in the messenger RNA, and creating the active site of the peptidyl transferase enzyme that links amino acids together during translation. In the final step of protein synthesis, two distinct types of molecular chaperones guide the folding of polypeptide chains. The chaperones known as HSP60 and HSP70 recognize exposed hydrophobic patches on proteins and serve to prevent the protein aggregation that would otherwise compete with the folding of newly synthesized proteins into their correct three-dimensional conformations. This protein folding process must also compete with an elaborate quality control mechanism that destroys proteins with abnormally exposed hydrophobic patches. In this case, ubiquitin is covalently added to a misfolded protein by a ubiquitin ligase, and the resulting polyubiquitin chain is recognized by the cap on a proteasome that moves the entire protein to the interior of the proteasome for proteolytic degradation. A closely related proteolytic mechanism based on spatial degradation signals recognized by ubiquitin ligase is used to determine the lifetimes of many normally folded proteins. By this method, selected normal proteins are removed from the cell in response to specific signals.